My name is David Corbel, and I serve as foremost and vice president for academic affairs here at Emporia State University. It's a real pleasure to welcome you to the 2017 Resurgent Creativity Day. Even at a time of the year when we hold lots of events where we recognize achievement, Resurgent Creativity Day for me stands out as something really special. Because this is the university's annual showcase where we point attention at the work that faculty and students do outside the regular classroom. This is really important because advancing knowledge through research and creative activity is simply a part of what a university is supposed to do. It's a part of our mission. Here at Emporia State, you may or may not know, but one of our strategic goals is to make high-impact learning experiences a central part of what it means to be an ESU student. And you know, it doesn't get any more high-impact than for a student to do a research project or a creative project under the supervision of a faculty mentor. ESU has a proud tradition and history of faculty members getting students involved in that hands-on application of academic work. When that happens, it's pretty special because a faculty member is modeling what it means to be a scientist or to be a historian or to be a creative artist. And then the student learns from that mentor's example and develops skills under that direct supervision. So I just want to thank you, professors, who are here today for advancing knowledge in your fields, which is something you do all the time, and also for going that extra mile to show these students exactly how that is done. And to the students who are here with us today, I want to congratulate you on what you have accomplished. This morning, I got to sample some of the presentations, and the quality of the work is just so impressive. I hope very much that the projects that you are presenting today have been rewarding for you to do, but I know beyond any doubt whatsoever that in doing this work, you have developed some skills that are going to have a broad application beyond these projects. So, thank you all for making us proud, and have a great day. Louder, $150 representing.
we'll go over to Dr. Quing Shi from MAP for the Phi Kappa Phi Abstract Awards.
Hello, my name is Zhang Shi. I'm a faculty member in the Department of Mathematics and Economics. I'm also the Vice President for the ESU Phi Kappa Phi Center. Our president, Ms. Carol Conley, cannot be here today because of a family emergency, so I'm substituting her to give the award. So each year, we give one award for the best undergraduate abstract and another award for the best graduate research project. So for this year, our judges, in fact, we have three faculty members serve as the judges. I want to recognize Eric and Harvard first. They are professors Sandra Bonney, you're here, can you stand up? And then Professor Dwight Mall and Professor Michael Burns. Yeah, let's thank them for their work. See you next year. The best undergraduate research abstract goes to Andy Peria and Kelly Schoenham. Their project is toward the synthesis of a G-specific fluorescent sensor. Andy and Kelly.
I think that speaks well of her. but she is the honorable mention.
Thank you.
Second recipient is Elena Buchanan, teaching assistant in the Department of Biological Sciences. He passed away in August 1986. We have two recipients for the Harold Durst Award. Recipients of this award must be completing a thesis or graduate degree program and must submit a research proposal that includes elements such as background significance of proposed research or creative activity, methodology, expected outcomes, and a budget. Budget is very important. The proposal format is the same as required of faculty competing for research and creativity awards. The first recipient is Randall Warbine, who's pursuing his master's degree in physical sciences with a concentration in earth science through the Department of Physical Sciences. Sun, who is pursuing her master's degree in biology. Modern Languages and Journalism.
One of the most powerful educational experiences that students can receive is the opportunity to work one-on-one with a faculty mentor on a project of shared interest. It is particularly valuable if this experience can be one that is intense, that has some resources behind, and in which all parties can participate for a considerable period of time. With that in mind, the Emporia State University Summer Undergraduate Research Program has been implemented and has blessed this campus for a number of years. We're very grateful for the funding that makes this possible as faculty and student pairs work together over the summer on projects of shared interest. Funding comes from KUMRI, the Provost's Office. Generally, each of the respective colleges with undergraduate students contribute, as well as the Honors College. And did I say the Provost's Office? I did, okay. So we're very grateful for this funding that makes this wonderful opportunity possible. As you'll notice, if you look at your program, a lot of the presentations, posters, and the like have a little asterisk by them, a red asterisk. This symbolizes that these presentations, this research, were research projects that were done last summer. We're pleased that we have projects that will be awarded this summer as well, teams that will be working. A little bit about how this works. Each student and faculty pair work together. If you come up with a proposal, a substantial proposal, I might add, submitted and evaluated by the VSU Undergraduate Research and Scholarly and Creative Activities Committee. And after a thorough evaluation, partnerships are awarded ESERT funding. Time doesn't permit me to name and give information about each of those that will be awarded this summer, but I've been asked to have all student and faculty pairs who will be working this summer, would you please stand and be recognized?
And at the Great American Market in Emporia in September. Will it support?
Thank you, Ms. Boswood. It is a great pleasure for me to present on behalf of President Gehr the 2017 President's Award for Research and Creativity. I will tell you right up front already who the recipient is. It is Dr. Eric Yang. Before I bring Dr. Yang up, I have a few things I want to tell you. First of all, I want to take just a moment to explain to you what this award is. This award was established in the year 1996, and its purpose is to honor an ECU faculty member, an ESU faculty member who has done outstanding work in research, scholarly activity, or creative endeavors. The nominations for the award come from other faculty members, and the selection of the winner is by a subcommittee of the ESU Faculty Research and Creativity Committee. Now I want to tell you something about Dr. Yang so you'll understand why he has been selected for this award. Dr. Yang is chair and associate professor in the Department of Biological Sciences. He received his PhD in molecular biology, microbiology, and biochemistry from Southern Illinois University at Carbondale in 2003. He joined the faculty here at ESU in 2005. Dr. Yang's research focuses on developing effective therapies against metastasized melanoma. In other words, he is a cancer researcher. Dr. Yang has developed two small molecules that significantly retard the growth and metastasis of melanoma. He has also discovered, and this is very interesting to me, he has discovered that vitamin C actually promotes the growth and invasiveness of melanoma. That's important because previously it was believed that vitamin C was beneficial to cancer treatment and prevention. Dr. Yang has also identified several plant chemicals from rosemary, ginger, ginkgo, and lavender that kill melanoma and prostate cancer cells and are capable of serving as alternative therapies options for invasive cancers. He and his research team continue to look for ways to improve treatment possibilities. And as stated by a colleague, and I'm quoting here, Dr. Yang's research achievements in advancing the understanding of cancer therapy have been extraordinary and exemplary, and his research productivity has gained international reputation not only for himself, but also for Emporia State University, end quote. Dr. Yang and his research team have received numerous research grants. They've published regularly in national and international peer-reviewed journals. He has been an invited speaker at many domestic and international conferences. In fact, he is scheduled to speak at the 10th annual World Cancer Congress in Barcelona, Spain, just next month. And maybe best of all, Dr. Yang's lab has consistently provided students with high-quality research experiences here at ESU. And as a result of that, many of his students have gone on to prestigious PhD programs, and quite a few of them today are distinguished researchers and lecturers in their own right. In connection with this award, Dr. Yang will receive $2,500, and his name will be added to the plaque that's on display in President Garrett's suite in Plum Hall. I'm also very pleased to present Dr. Yang with a blown glass award. As Dean Spotswood mentioned, I am instructed, since it is made of glass, to be very careful in presenting. So I will do my best to do that. And this time, I'll ask Dr. Yang to come forward.
However, I'm very honored to be humbled to receive this award. However, I don't think this work belongs to me, it belongs to my students. Because, you know, the student make it happen, and all the research have done only for students. Thank you very much.
Each submitting to the committee mountains of evidence of excellence in creative research and creativity. There we go. Dr. Yang, congratulations. But to all of the rest of the applicants, thank you. And please submit again, and other colleagues that you know are doing excellent work to submit again. A few closing remarks. This is my first Research and Creativity Day at ESU, and it's been, so far, a wonderful pleasure. This is a beautiful facility. I'm hoping you all are enjoying the lunch. But this just speaks about the efforts that faculty and students are doing, and faculty working with students and student engagement. Just think that that is fantastic. So congratulations to all. I wanted to close with just a few numbers. I'm a Shakespearean, as I mentioned, so take these numbers with a grain of salt. But I think I've gotten most of this right or nearly right, but there are 133 poster presentations this year. 133. We have basically taken up almost every square inch of web hall. There were 22 oral presentations there, and 11 3-minute thesis contestants, all of an extremely high quality. Faculty awards were recognized today in excess of $3,500. Grants for faculty and student research totaled over $60,000 recognized there. Student awards and scholarship money, nearly $10,000. This is, bespeaks some really good work on behalf of you all, and I think we should recognize that. So thank you all. From the stage, I want to recognize a few more people. To my organizer, script writer, and choreographer, Pam Fillmore. Also, their assistants, others from the graduate school, Carrie Jackson, Ashley Huey, Yesenia Vasquez, Jan Gershner, and holding down the fort while all of them were working, Mary Sewell and Jenny Jang and Brandy Turner, all from the graduate school of distance education. If you would, please, a round of applause. I invite you all to attend the poster display from 1 to 3. See all the wonderful work that is being presented out there. We also have door prizes, which will be being presented at 2 o'clock and 3 o'clock. So make sure you get your names in for those drawings. There are a lot of really good and cool gifts, including a couple of bags from Granada Chocolate that you guys are lucky you're still here. Also, a quick note, awardees, if you will, please stay after for briefly for some pictures. Otherwise, please enjoy yourselves and enjoy.